Okay, thank you. So I will try to bring you the third perspective of this project, that was a technological one. Because today we have listened to two languages that are not technical at all. So you have to think how technical people may gain benefit from the result of this project. Because really, the languages are very different. So the idea was to develop some tools that may be a starting point. I mean, this field are far from our background, but this field are useful to make a better work. So how to make closer the different field? Well, and this is my question, maybe using gaming, maybe using playful tools that may be fastly and easily addressed and may give you an inspiration, may give you an idea that may help you to take care of things you are not used to do in your work. So this is my Mentimer question, hoping to convince you that gaming may be useful also in learning, and you may agree or disagree with this question. So, we have developed three tools. They are different. All of them have some gaming or playing aspect inside. The first one is called the Interactive Toolbox. It's somehow a different way of looking at what is in the roadmap and in the book that Catherine was presenting before. Because here we just took some hints from all the tests and completed them with some small games, just to give you an idea, and I will show you in a while. The second one I show you, and it's also on your on some of your table, is this one that is called Billbot, and it's a board game with the aim of entering another phase of the development process. And the third one that is still in final development, so I will not be able to show you today, is Brickster. That is an online game, again, to help technical people to understand how looking at the end user may help the design process. So, starting from Brickster that we will not see later, it's a game that drive you through a story in the whole design process. And at each step of your design process, you have to encounter and discuss with stakeholders to make some choices on the way you will go on. And you will understand that each choice you do influences what happens later. So, again, the main aim is to help technical people to understand that choice you do at the beginning are still there at the end, and vice versa. Moving to the Reeler Toolbox. I need to go online. It's here. And it's here. OK. It's a website where we reported all the concepts of the project, and we tried to divide the content coming from the project in two parts. The one that may help people while developing, so hints and suggestions while developing a product, and other concepts that show the why aspect of development. I mean, you develop a product, and normally when you develop a product, you are thinking of what you are developing. You have difficulties to look far away from that. But once in the society, robots have also effects and implications that you were not thinking of. Not all of them are responsibility of the developers, but it's a good point the developers are able to know all of this. And for all the different aspects we will consider, we have also quotes from the field, spoken quotes from the field. And I think that this is very important. I have always said to Catherine that for me this is an added value of this project for technical people, because these are information coming from people, coming from real users, are not a social scientist coming to us to say, well, you have to do this and this and this, but are hints for reflection on what is the effect on society. However, I would like to show you a couple of interactive games, just to give you an idea. This one of the themes is inclusive design. And this is a game we propose for inclusive design. Inclusive design, its aim to be able to design in a way able to include as much people as possible. But as much as possible does not mean all. So you may start here. You are equipped with six coins. You may use to do something in your process. Okay? The first choice, we have to develop something working on the end, is, well, which end we want to study? We want to develop a product able to be used by right and the left end, or only right and only left-handed people. You know that the cost of these are different. You say, okay, I want to be very inclusive. I selected this one. Stine, I need your help. I am not able to make a selection.
You're going to proceed?
Yeah, it's my fault, sorry, I don't understand. I don't understand my own. No, sorry for that. So I said right and left-handed. And then you go on. And you have a second choice. You have to select between a male, female, or male and female. Well, if you want to be very inclusive, we may say, OK, I want a male and female. I think it's the best solution. And you think you have include most of all. But now you have no more resources. You have no more money. And you know there is people with a small end. It's not important if they're women or men. There are people with other problems in the end, arthritis, and so on. So this is just to show, in a very simple way, how your choice cannot be universal, because you are not able to cover everything. But in the same time, you have to take into account the resources you have. And this was an idea. I give you another idea. That is this one. One of the themes we have discussed also today is imaginaries. Imaginaries of end user may affect a lot our development work. And we have to take into account that people may have different ideas, maybe curious ideas about what a robot is. So this, for example, is a robot to make coffee, okay? And here you have the presentation by very good advertising people. They give you a lot of good points, ergonomic condition, smart technology, consistent process, nice words. And a lot of possibility to collect the cherries of coffee. But then you may move to what is behind it. And you see difference, ergonomic. Why ergonomic? What means ergonomics? Smart technology, well, is in technical term a closed-loop feedback system. What does it mean? It's something different, for sure, according to the degree of ripeness. But only for two coffee plants, and only on plain terrain, and so on. This is just to give you an idea of how advertising or marketing or what people think is different from realities. And I suggest that you go. I need to change my glasses. No. Live show.
To the slides?
Yes. Yep. From here. Thank you. And you have a lot of this kind of suggestion. This is the link, the URL, but you may reach it also from the homepage. And last but not least, the Billbot, that is our favorite game, board game. Oh, here, the point was to help developers and mainly students, in our experience, we see that it's very useful for students, to understand how it may be difficult to collect the input from people, from users. So here it's a board game, you have a board, and you have four types of stakeholder or potential user. It's a case of an healthcare robot here, it's a rehabilitation robot we will go to develop. And you are able to get input from policymaker, therapist, robots buyers, and patient. According to the model that Catherine was showing before, they are in different circle of our human proximity model. So moving on the board, you stop on the different point, and you are able to take paying, to take one comment from one of the different stakeholders. You read the comment from the stakeholder, and then you have to go on in your development process. How? Well, looking at specification, as we call, so at a feature of the robot that fit well or less well the point. And you have four types of specification. You have a human-robot interaction, you have education and training, you have safety and privacy, and you have involvement of stakeholders. So the game is in fitting in the best way what stakeholders tell to you, and which are the features of the robot. You may make your match, and then all the other players may judge if it's good or not. It's a way to learn, because really, in the development work, one of the most difficult tasks is to be able to extract knowledge from what people say to you. OK, so I think that it's almost time to play.
Thank you very much, Maria.